Matt Dillon and Rooster Cogburn have nothing on a ragtag band of cowpokes wrestling with aliens for the Western way of life. But does cowboys and aliens withstand the clash of genres? Find out right now on Movieology. Whoa! Where'd the aliens come from? It's 1873, Arizona Territory. Jake Lonergan, a stranger with no memory of his past, stumbles into the hard desert town of Absolution. The only hint of his history is a mysterious shackle that encircles one wrist. What he discovers is Absolution don't welcome strangers, and nobody makes a move on its streets unless ordered to do so by the iron-fisted Woodrow Dollarhide. But unexpectedly screaming down with breathtaking velocity and blinding lights to abduct the helpless one by one, supposed demons challenge everything the residents have ever known. Now the stranger they rejected is their only hope for salvation. With the help of the elusive traveler, Ella, said stranger pulls together a posse comprised of Dollarhide's gang, other outlaws, and Apache warriors, all in danger of annihilation. Cowboys and Aliens stars Daniel Craig, Harrison Ford, and Olivia Wilde. It was directed by Jon Favreau. Welcome to Movieology, your ticket to engaging the spectacular world of film from the bedrock of biblical truth. I'm Joseph Darnell. In news surrounding Movieology, we're still working on another show that will be a part of the Movieology family. We want to answer more of, you know, the viewers' questions in this other program, but also deal with random topics about film that Movieology isn't suited well for. Movieology is a review show that sometimes helps moviegoers to better review films on their own. This other show would be much broader and address movie news, answer your questions, be interactive. So if you have any suggestions for what we might call this other show, we'd love to hear them, because frankly, we're just about out of ideas, and it's tempting to just call the show The Show without a title, but that really wouldn't serve our purpose as much. So if you can help us out with this, offering some title suggestions, it'd be greatly appreciated. And we'd reserve a special place in our hearts just for you. Cowboys and Aliens had me wondering whether, you know, it would come out feeling like a Western or a sci-fi. And the answer to this question is yes. I was surprised by how many of the genre conventions were upheld. It's quite a Western and a sci-fi without shorting one or the other. Oddly enough, Westerns and sci-fis have many similar undercurrent story conventions. In the tradition of classic Westerns, Cowboys and Aliens has a mysterious man of the West who swaggers into town, seeking redemption and managing heroics to earn it. And like many Space Invader flicks, the film reveals otherworldly predators that unite mankind in a fight to the death. The technical quality of the film is mostly impressive, but usually it just meets the bare minimum of my expectations. The cinematography was good, but not great. The film soundtrack was clearly meant to be a Western, and it sounds beautiful. The acting is above average, but nothing remarkable, except for Daniel Craig. And then the special effects are flawless, but also uninspired, as the film's aliens and their technology look a whole lot like aliens and their technology from most all sci-fis. Filmmakers gruesomely exploit amphibians and insects everywhere. But also, what disappoints in Cowboys and Aliens is just how well it sticks to the conventions of their genres without a strong plot to give them depth. Most of the townsfolk and Indians are Western cliches, while the stupid yet super intelligent aliens are smart enough to get themselves to Earth and then cause tremendous amounts of mayhem, they still find ways to hold themselves back to give mankind a sporting chance to kick them to kingdom come. Does this sound like a superior alien race? It does by Hollywood standards. And in many ways, the story is like a spiritual journey. Our hero is an awful sinner, a wanted outlaw. Thanks to a close encounter of the third kind of supposed demons, he realizes he must radically change his life to save not just his soul, but also to avenge his murdered love. Now a man of valor, our cowboy faces his mortal monster foes, and with the help of an angelic being, he succeeds in his righteous cause to thwart supernatural-like powers and purge the town of Absolution of all evildoers. The end result is lawmen and lawbreakers find reconciliation and peace in fighting a righteous cause as a united force. From murderous outlaw to human savior, Jake Lonergan is a pioneer of redemption. Yeehaw! Spiritual stuff is brought up all throughout. Crucifixes are an occasional symbol for God's grace. The respected preacher tells Jake to help the others, encouraging him with, "God don't care who you were, son, only who you are." The preacher also tells Jake, "Whether you end up in heaven or hell, it's not God's plan, it's your own." When an ally dies, someone prays, "If there is such a thing as a soul, this man had a good one. Please protect it." Talking about a loved one our hero has lost, Dollar Hyde says, "She's in a better place." So is Cowboys and Aliens a God-honoring film? Chew on that while we thank our sponsor. American Vision is dedicated to restoring America's biblical foundation. They have invaluable resources for history, apologetics, eschatology, and worldview studies. As a movieology fan, you are treated to 10% off all purchases at AmericanVision.com when you use the coupon code Hollywood at checkout. American Vision is the ministry that will help you understand the world you live in. For movieology fans, we recommend you check out Hollywood Worldviews, what we call the Bible of movieology. You'll find it at AmericanVision.com. So, Joe, are you saying that this movie has a Christian worldview? I only wish. I should note that many Westerns and alien sci-fis use Christian themes as almost standard fare, as though they aren't being true to their genres without including Christian or anti-Christian themes. But this film is heavily influenced by other popular faiths as well. I tend to like a story that is built on one worldview that is either hot or cold. Either you're wholly Christian or wholly other. This film, though, stays lukewarm to be on the safe side, mooching off of several worldviews. Cowboys and Aliens is three parts Christianity, one part New Age, Unitarianism, humanism, and Indian stuff. All this poured into the same glass, then shaken, not stirred. So what you end up with is pseudo-Christianity. There is no doubt in my mind that the worldview taken is what Hollywood would like Christianity to be, open and accepting of worldly wisdom, which is in fact error and only exploits God's word to justify a sense of authority. I give Cowboys and Aliens 3.5 stars out of 5. The plot is weak, but told in a novel way. It's a fun genre shakeup. I didn't appreciate most of the unoriginal characters, but their setting, style, heroism, self-sacrifice, and general support of masculine responsibilities were appreciated. It's also nice that the main protagonist isn't exactly the most influential of the heroes at the end of the day. When it's all said and done, it's a thought-provoking juxtaposition that suffers from postmodernism and genre conventionality. So that's it, ladies and gents. We'd love it if you would add your own short review or insights in a comment. Remember to watch Movieology on the website, movieology.tv, the source for worldview enthusiast news, reviews, and discussion of all things film. You can also find us on iTunes, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and in your inbox if you sign up for Movieology's free e-newsletter on the website. And please do us a favor, share Movieology with your friends and family that like to discuss movies. I'm Joseph Darnell. Until next time, thank you for watching Movieology. Now somebody needs to clean up that smelling alien off the floor, please. Jake Lonergan is a pioneer of redemption. Redemption? What? No! That was supposed to be the last take. Aliens. Stewart and his aliens. Without a strong plot to back them up with depth. What? Let me get this gun out of my pants. Those two were for kicks and giggles. Yay! You know, yeehaw! Spiritual... You got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said. Boy, you've got a friend in me. Some of the folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too, maybe. But none of them would ever love you the way I do. It's me and you. All right.
Joe, these things are expensive.